What's up, castaways? It's Miles Away. Welcome back to another Friday video on music production, sound design, and more. So today, Chase Bliss Audio were nice enough to send over this pedal right here. So I wanted to show you guys a musical context of how I would use it to create textures and atmospheres in my track. There's already a lot of really good videos online showcasing how to use the Chase Bliss Audio MOOD, so I'm not going to be doing a review, I'm not going to be doing a full overview of all of the features, and it won't be a tutorial. Instead, I'm going to try to show you guys in a really musical, usable context how I use the Chase Bliss Audio MOOD in my tracks to create really great sounding and unique textures through its granular engine. In this first section, we're going to feed audio into my MOOD from different sources and chop it up using the granular engine to create textures. In the second section, we're going to bring that audio into Logic and further chop it up to create interesting textures that fit well with the arrangement of the song. Let's jump into Logic and check out what our intro track's going to sound like. So while it's a good start, it's definitely missing that special something to elevate it to the next level. So let's jump on over to the MOOD and record some atmospheres for this track. Alright, so we've got this sound on the deluge. Let's put it through the MOOD and see what the MOOD can do with it. So the MOOD can be a simple reverb. And despite the fact the reverb's in mono, I think it sounds really amazing. So let's start off by recording the chord progression that we have for our demo track using this sound and using the MOOD as a reverb pedal. Now, although that reverb sounded lovely, where the real beauty of the MOOD is for creating textures is in the right side of the pedal by Drolo Effects. Now, this red light is a looper that's constantly listening and recording into a buffer. Now, what we're gonna do, we're gonna play a chord on our synth, record it into the looper, and then start mangling it using the different effects and the clock. For creating textures, I really like to use either stretch or tape. For this first loop, we're gonna use tape to really get that wonderful tapey reversed sound. So we have our loop here. It's constantly repeating. I'm going to go ahead and reverse it. We add this wonderful lo-fi tape warble to our loop. Now what we're going to do, we're going to go ahead and bring in the reverb. Now for our next texture, we're going to take a more percussive sound, in this case, a sample of a Rhodes. We're going to run it into the looper, and we're going to get a granular cloud using the stretch mode. Sounds beautiful already. I love the stretch mode on the MOOD for creating textures because of how emotional and sensitive it is. Granular synthesis, which is really what this is. It's an incredible little granular synthesizer in a box, creates, in my opinion, the most lush textures. Now this time around, we're gonna dial in some delay. That sounds pretty weird. All right, so for the final part of our sound, we're gonna go and turn it up an octave with the clock while bringing back in a little bit more quality. That is beautiful right there. All right, for our final texture here, we're gonna go back to the tape mode and we're gonna use a piano sample. There we go. Listen to that degraded sounding loop. That is simply beautiful. We'll reverse it. Now, it's important to look at the relationship between the clock and the speed of the loop, because we could easily just turn the clock up. But then we go back to the higher quality sound, and I don't want high quality. I want a lower, emotional, degraded tape loop. And then let's bathe it in reverb. Wow, listen to that. That is simply beautiful. All right, so the first thing I like to do when I'm making textures is I like to find some sort of interesting texture that, while it may have some dissonance, mainly centers around the root note of our chord. So let's go check that out. I like that one a lot because it's up an octave, so it won't clash too much with the lower frequencies, and we won't have to do too much work to get it to fit in. I've added it to our intro piano, and watch how just one texture with this kind of granular pad sound that the Mood is so good at creating will elevate this intro. Immediately, it's more emotional, it's more human, it's more fragile. All right, so the next thing we're going to do here is we're going to try to find a texture that can act as a little bit more of a repetitive rhythmic motif, kind of like how you'd use an arpeggiator. What this is going to do is this is going to really give context to the song melodically while repeating itself enough to be sort of in the background and not taking too much attention to itself. All right, so I really like this Rhodes atmosphere. Now what I'm gonna do is chop it up so it makes an interesting one bar textural melody for our song. All right, so I've chopped it up into this one bar loop and it's not perfect, but the beauty is it doesn't have to be perfect because that can kind of add to the interestingness and uniqueness of it. We're gonna add some reverb to this and delay. And then quickly fade in the intro of each one so there's no clicking sound. And that sounds beautiful. Now watch as we mix in this repetitive texture with the track, how much it's going to bring it to life rhythmically while still being melodically what we want to hear. All right, so for the final texture here, I'm going to take the piano and create a sort of melodic downlifter that happens at the beginning of each phrase. Let's check it out. All right, so I've taken the note that I like the most from our noisy granular piano, and I've looped it 4 times, and I'm adding some tape delay onto it to create a sort of unique homemade downlifter that's going to happen at the beginning of each of our chords. Sounds like this. All right, let's mix this together a little bit and see how it sounds. Alright guys, that about does it for today. Remember to hit that like button, subscribe, and check out my Patreon if you enjoyed my video. I'm going to be posting all of the samples that I made today with the Mood there. Now, a final note to end off. I hope this video is able to inspire you, even if you guys don't have a Chase Bliss Audio MOOD. Because remember, at the end of the day, it's not about the gear that you don't have, it's about using the gear that you do have to create beautiful music. That's what this channel is all about, and thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video.